Hi guys, Scruffosaurus here with The Authentic Gamer, and today we'll be bringing you the Netgear AC1900. This is a dual band 2.4 and 5 gigahertz router with a 1 gigahertz processor, as you can see in the lid right here. Let's get right to this. Short and sweet. Here we have the router. It's a big boy. Obviously it comes with your packets, information, all that good stuff. This has three external powered antennas to help boost range, a basic cable, and the power supply. They do a vertical kind of power adapter here so that we are not taking up a bunch of space on a power strip. That's always super appreciated. This does G, N, AC, anything you can think of. Killing it. Alright, let's get this bad boy out. Here's where the three antennas go. Boom, boom, and then boom. Here you have a power button, which it is about freaking time. I mean, for real. I'm getting real tired of pulling the plug out and putting it back in. All of your lights are right here. Let me take this protective film off, huh? Maybe you can see that a little better. Here we have all your different bands, the ports, everything. Here's your wired ports. You have a USB 2.0 on the back and a USB 3.0 right there on the front. Super awesome for making this into kind of like a file sharing hub. You can put little files in there, music, or whatever you want to kind of share between computers. Next, we will be doing a speed comparison with a wired connection to the computer with my previous router, which is a WNDR 3300. It's kind of old. And then this bad boy. Alrighty, we'll get started with the wired test first to get a basis for the speeds that can be expected from the routers. First, let's look at what a wired connection directly from that modem to my computer provides. I am using a 5-foot gold-plated Cat6 wire to ensure optimal speeds. During this test, my modem was able to obtain low ping in the 9 to 13 millisecond range and download speeds in the 100 megabits per second range, with uploads of around 4.3 megabits. The advertised speeds for my ISP are 100 megabits per second down and 5 megabits per second up, so the speeds I am actually able to obtain are pretty spotty on, even though I would gladly give half my download speed for just double the upload. Now we will move on to the wire test for the WNDR 3300 from Netgear. My WNDR 3300 was not providing me with my max throughput anymore, even with a very short wired connection. This test is running off of a gold-plated Cat6 wire, so speed should never be an issue like it was here. I have had this router for many years, and it is getting old, but a wired connection should not be straining to provide me with 60 megabits per second, much less the 100 megabits per second. At least the ping was still good, and my upload speeds were pretty close to what I expected. One other downside is that Netgear no longer supports this router. It has not received a firmware update in 5 plus years, and is not compatible with the Netgear Genie. Lastly, for our wire test, we analyzed the Netgear Nighthawk AC1900D7000 router. This test went very well. My ping was low, on average of 10 milliseconds. And download speeds were pushing 100% capacity, providing me with 110 megabits per second. Also, upload speeds were the same as the direct connection to the modem. This is what you should expect from a good wired connection from your router. The Nighthawk has 4 gigabyte ports, meaning it will provide you with up to 1 gigabits per second speed. Conversely, the WNDR 3300 has a 10/100 megabit port. They used to provide me with close to 100 megabits per second, but have been bringing lower speeds as of late. Now for the Wi-Fi test. Going back to the WNDR 3300, we will test the 2.4 GHz band first. As you can see, the tests were all over the place, but in general, the download speeds are in the teens to 20-ish megabits per second range. Upload speeds were variable as well, and ping could skyrocket to 100 milliseconds sometimes. All tests were performed at approximately 30 plus feet away from the router to help provide a basis for performance at a distance. Next, we have the test results for the AC1900 on the 2.4 GHz band, and what an improvement. The powered antennas grant amazing range on the 2.4 GHz band, which provided me with a solid connection throughout my entire house and even the basement. With download speeds in the 50 megabits per second range, it had more than doubled what I was able to get with the WNDR3300. Upload speeds were rock solid as well, giving me the max my ISP is providing. Also, the ping is in a comfortable 45 millisecond range. Lastly, for a bit of showboating from the AC1900, we test the 5 GHz channel on the Nighthawk. At 30 plus feet away, it was supplying max throughput of 110 megabits per second. To be able to push that speed at a decent range is quite impressive. Again, bringing max upload speeds and a solid performance with an almost locked-in ping of 45 milliseconds. The 2.4 GHz channel can receive interference with things like microwaves and cordless phones, not to mention everyone else's 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi channel in your area. Having 5 GHz really helps remove unwanted variances in your Wi-Fi, and also provide you with some impressive throughput. Thank you everybody for watching. Feel free to ask questions in the comments below, and like the video if it helped you. Subscribe to our channel and go to our website, theauthenticgamer.com, and please check out the links in the description. I am Scruffosaurus with Tag, and we will see you next time.